Welcome everyone to Crafting on a Budget. I want to share with you guys my beautiful junk journal using the digital designs that I had created for a kit called the Romantique. And it is pretty chunky as you guys can see. I had just a little bit left over from the kit. I utilized a good majority of everything that was there. And this here, I put one of the images for the front, along with some trims, and I love the way I did this. I took the vintage lace, ruffled it up, and wrapped it in the back. And in the back, I had this little scrap here piece of an applique laying on my desk from my other project. That was gifted to me from Young Soo, so I thought, you know what, it kind of goes with the color scheme here, so we just popped it in there. So I kind of like the way it looked. It is fabric, but all the pages are paper, and we did a blind binding on that. There's a tassel. Now there is a bead tutorial on how to do this bohemian wrap. It's the same concept, and this is just a paper clip that I added a lot of little goodies and attached it to my tassel here. So let's see what's inside. All right. So the kit had all kinds of yummy stuff in it, and this was pretty fun. It's pretty lengthy. I have two more videos for those that purchased the kit to watch, but I wanted to show you guys the finished look. So I took the metals that were in the kit, I attached it here, glued it together, and there you go. I sewed around the edges, did a little bit of patchwork. These are the popsicle sticks, and I used just little scraps of stuff that was in the kit to make my little popsicle sticks. Kind of put it there in that pocket. And this is a paper clip, or a clothespin, actually, not paper clip, a clothespin. Tons of little layers of the fabrics and trims and miscellaneous stuff that was in the kit, and I attached it to the clothespin, and that goes there. Did some stitching, patchwork. Now all the pages are coffee dyed, so kind of like the way that looked. This is just a pocket with a little button there, being held with a stitch down here. More stitch work. I love to be able to stitch and do almost like a patchwork, so if here you can write and here you can tuck something. There's that one. Do more writing. Coffee dyed the pages. Again, you can tuck something behind that one. Here is a library card that's in the kit, and tucked it in. Voila. Another little pull out with graphic paper. More writing, more writing, tons of writing. And then this is a paper clip that I altered using some of the goodies from the kit, and that's going to be, I think, in part 6 of the tutorial. You'll see that, how I did that, either 6 or 7, because there's 6 parts to this. This was like a lengthy tutorial, guys. So for those of you guys that purchased this kit, you guys had lengthy tutorials, but at least it gives you something to look at. So then we have that, put some of the laces here, and then we have that. I didn't make a pocket there, sorry. Got that page, little tag here, and there, that is a pocket, so you can tuck something in there. Took one of the ephemeras, took the bulb pin, attached some laces from the kit with some buttons that were also in the kit, and that's a little pull out there. And over here again, just it's amazing what you can do with little pieces of just scraps just to create cute little embellishments. Again, another little envelope with some pull outs and things. And here's another popsicle stick that I used pieces of the things that were in the kit. go. Here's another paper clip or a clothespin. I want to say paper clip, but it's a clothespin with random scraps. This is like the velvet piece there. And there's a little envelope that was in the kit as well. Jesus Loves Me. And I just attached that with a piece of chipboard to give it dimensional. And I like the random stitching, so that to me is my favorite. And then I use some bold pens to go on the corner here. More pull-outs. The metals on the corners. I guess I should zoom in, because it seems like you guys are so far away. Okay, there we go. Maybe you can see it now. Another one. Again, just random patchwork stitching. It just gives it a right unique look. And there we go. We attach this little tag with some stitching. This one has verse Matthew 22, verse 37 and 39. Jesus replied, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself." Pretty strong verse, huh? Love it. Okay, so here's another popsicle stick with random pieces of scraps. There's a pocket that was in the kit. And with the scraps, you can make this little cute paper clip that you can attach random stuff to it. And I just glued it onto this little tag. Another one. Another pull out there. Little ephemeras. Here's a little pocket. I guess we could put something in there. I didn't put anything in there. Ha ha. Alright. Well, so there you go. Another one. This is an old library card too. Here's another little pocket that was sewn in. It's a pretty chunky book. More writing. I don't know about you guys. I don't normally write on mine. And this is a side pullout. This one's Isaiah 26:3. "You will keep in perfect peace him whose mind is steadfast because he trusts in you." I love the stitch work. It's just random stitch work. Just gives it a really neat, unique look. And over here, "Seek the Lord." Joshua 1:8. "Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful." Amen, amen, amen. All right. There's a little pocket there that you can put in as well, something. And I took the bulb, and this is a little piece of velvet lace or trim that was in the kit, added some buttons and attached it to that, made a little pocket with the craft paper that was in the kit with some random patchwork as well. Here's another one of those popsicle sticks with a doily piece of fabric. I folded it in half. This is all in the kit, frayed the edges, and loop-de-loop the lace and attached a button there. So, pretty nice. It's like little bookmarks. Alright. There's another little pocket. This is in the envelope that we folded in half, attached it to it, and voila. Easy peasy, right? That was a real simple little pull out right there. A side pocket, and again, a bold pen with some buttons and some of the scraps that were in the kit. I love this one here. I have another tutorial on how I take wax paper, coffee dye it, and stitch it up. So this is just one that we did in this kit. A little card. Attach a piece of metal and a pearl. And then there's another tag. More ephemeras, and here's another one of those little bow pins with the lace, and I just love this little bow pins with the buttons. This looks cute, and you see how cute. You don't have to have a whole chunk of anything, but look, just little pieces of tad bits of stuff. This gives it a unique look. Here's another card with piece of trim that was in the kit. And what's this verse? Psalms 37:4, delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Some very strong words. God is such an amazing God. Gotta love him. And woman of God. And there's a tutorial on this. I can't remember if it was 6 or 7, but I showed you guys how to take the We Are Memory Keeper tab punch board and create that. And we also created this one. I attached one of the medals that was in the kit. And this is one of the music sheets, made a tab. And then I just took a piece of the lace that was in the kit, attached it to that. And we can tuck that on the side of that medal, like that. Well, I think we're almost there, a piece of trim there. Nothing fancy. Nothing fancy. And I think that's it. You know, we did, again, like I said, we did a blind stitch, and I think it turned out cute. I used some of the flatbacks attached it to my seam binding that was in the kit. It's pretty neat. I love the way it turned out. It looks so vintage, so grungy. I love the grunginess and the feel of everything, the fabric with the papers and the coffee dyed. It's crinkly, and I don't know, just beautiful. Isaiah 40:31, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Amazing. So this has a lot of little Bible verses in it. Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I tell you guys, I get cold chills just reading these. John 3:16, oh, I love this verse. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have ever eternal life. That is some strong, powerful words. I love it. So yeah, I hope you guys love the outcome of this. And if you guys have any questions, I know there's going to be a second version of the digital aspect of the kit. You're not going to have the laces and all the pretty stuff, but I have someone working on trying to, you guys know I go to graphic school. You're probably wondering, oh, well, you do graphic, why aren't you working on it? Well, the reason being is that I can't do everything, you know, it's kind of hard, but I outsource somebody that can create something for you guys to give you guys a different feel. So if you guys want to implement it in this kit, you can, or just create another beautiful book. And I just love the way this turned out. I think it turned out really stinking cute. I did 3 layers of the laces. I have the one here, the gimp, and then a pretty pink, and then this one, this ruffled, and then that little burgundy one. And I think it went well, so good together. It just looks great. I love it, love it, love it. And at one point I thought, I would flip the other side because the other side has all kinds of fibers and stuff of this fabric, and I loved it. I loved the way it looked, but I'm glad I went with doing it the right way. So, and then here I just used a scrap, a piece of the fabric that was in the kit, and just kind of put it on my spine there. And I love the way it also looks. So it all went so well, so beautiful, so vintagey looking, and so romantic. So anyway, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this. For those of you guys that purchased the kit, thank you so much for purchasing the kit. I will be surely to put out more to come. And as you guys know, my daughter has reopened shop. We're working on getting everything set and ready, and within the next couple weeks you guys will have beautiful laces to enjoy, and medals as well. So just stay tuned for that, and stay tuned for the next kit, because I'm sure you guys are going to love it. Till next time, guys, bye bye.